According to experts, the Freedom Day in England 100 days ago, with the end of almost all corona rules, did not give the economy the hoped-for boost. The demand is enormous and restaurant bookings are well above the level before the pandemic, said economist Liz Martens from the major bank HSBC to the German press agency in London. But the recovery is still not complete. Consumer-oriented services are still well below the pre-crisis level. On July 19th, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson lifted almost all corona rules in England. Distance rules and mask requirements are no longer mandatory. Nightclubs, discos and pubs can receive guests indefinitely and without presenting a vaccination certificate. Health in Great Britain is a matter of the parts of the country, so the nations. Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland have now also ended many corona rules, but they don't go quite as far as England, which does not have its own regional government. The labour shortage in particular is a problem for some industries. The so-called pingdemic contributed to this, said Michael Stelmach from the consulting firm KPMG to the DPA. In the summer, many people were pinged by the corona app because of close contact with infected people. That means notified and they had to stay away from work. The size and speed of the reopening have revealed some acute problems in meeting demand, said Stelmach. As a result, there was a shortage of goods and labor, and there were also problems within the supply chain, such as the bottlenecks in semiconductors, which hindered the global production process. But whatever was there globally, Brexit exacerbated it in England. At the moment, the labour shortage is still affecting industries such as the hospitality and entertainment industries, as Martin said. For example, some restaurants have stopped their lunch specials. According to a survey by the industry association Nighttime Industries Association, every fifth company had to close in September due to a lack of doorman and security staff, or was only able to open to a limited extent. Overall, there are 30% more vacancies than before the pandemic, said Martens. In the opinion of the expert, the fact that many people continue to work from home also means that economic strength falls short of expectations. After all, this not only affects gastronomy, but also many businesses related to office infrastructure, such as transport, maintenance, and cleaning services. The corona numbers are currently increasing again. Although the government does not want to impose any new restrictions, some people might decide for themselves that they want to reduce their social contacts, said Martens. The boom in opening times is over, said KPMG economist Stelmach. Mobility data showed that retail and leisure facilities are now about as busy as they were before the pandemic. Stelmach pointed out that the gross domestic product is still 0.8% below the value before the pandemic. The expert has no positive expectations for the future either. Consumers would have to fear sharply rising energy and living costs, which is already putting pressure on the buying mood. He expects high inflation of 4.1% by the end of the year, plus an imminent significant increase in taxes. The expected rise in interest rates would also burden homeowners with variable mortgages, said Stelmach. This is one of the reasons why consumers have held back with spending. Money is basically available. The savings in July and August would have increased by £7.5 billion, and it's quite a lot. I'll see you in my next video. Bis gleich.